find all of the auto design options on this auto design button here, just above the image well. It's in this menu you can set the parameters for your auto design. It's here you can select how many pages you'd wish to design, how many images you would like to use, and you can also set both the minimum and maximum spread per image. You can also select the design and style of the album, the aspect ratio, the entire collection, or just a filtered amount of images, and also capture date, file name, or a custom order. Once you hit design, you will have a rough draft of how your album will look. By default, Fundy Designer will group your images together by the timestamp on your images. So don't forget, if you are using multiple cameras and multiple shooters on your wedding or portrait session, make sure that all cameras are synced together with both time and date. While the auto design is quite accurate, it's never perfect, but don't forget, you can always move your spreads around depending on the size and feel of your wedding album. Also, if you feel that the image needs to be moved, you can always drag and something over here, as well as scroll and quickly select a different spread. You can even select photos and make a new page. Also in Fundy Designer, you can edit each individual drop zone depending on your needs by simply clicking on the image, highlighting it, and dragging the individual image to suit the requirement of the album. You can then spend the next 5 or 10 minutes just tweaking the design to get a perfect rough draft to show to your client. The auto design has the ability to change your settings to get exactly what you want. If you have imported the entire gallery and then using Fundy software 5-starred your favourites for the album, you can then filter the images by clicking filter and then selecting 5 stars, seeing we've only got 58 of 210 images now selected. I now go to auto design and select filtered images, and we go from 210 to 58 images. I can now change my page count, and this will adjust the average amount of images it will place per spread. In addition to album, I can select a signing book, a baby book, a family album, and the Graphic Studio matted album. Under aspect ratio, we can also make a different selection here. 3x2 is the default, but we can also go to the original accent, match the original, or mixed. Let's do 3x2 on all images to give you an example. You will now notice that no matter how we have shot the images in camera, every image in the album now has a 3x2 ratio. When using auto design, we have the ability to tell Fundy software how to use our images. If you double click on any image or click on this logo, you will open up the image browser. In any of these three views, gallery view, thumbnail view, or compare, you have the ability to tag photos that will influence the auto design. The three main buttons are main image, cover photo, and panorama. To make your selected image the cover photo, simply click on the image and then click cover photo. And you will see the selected image now has the cover logo just here by the 5 stars. Alternatively, select the image and hit C. So now when we click auto design and design, the image we have selected for the cover now appears here. When you are scrolling through your images and making your selection for the final album and you see an image that you think would be perfect for a panoramic, simply click and click panorama. Alternatively, you can hit the P key. In doing so, you will see the panoramic logo next to the 5 stars. So now, when we hit the auto design and design button, you will see that we now have the cover option, which is here, and the panorama, which is here. So simply click and adjust to taste. If you are finding that when you are pressing auto design, Fundy software is splitting your images across the spreads, it is very simple to group the photos together. This is very useful when shooting with multiple cameras and multiple photographers at your wedding or portrait shoot, especially when you have multiple photographers both covering the bride and the groom at the same time. Based solely on timestamp, Fundy Designer will instinctively split these images across different spreads. We can select multiple images and hit the group button, or select multiple images and hit the G key. So now when we hit auto design, not only do we have the images selected for the cover photo here, the panorama here, we also have these images, and these images grouped together on the same spread. Finally, within the grouped set of images, we have the ability to make one image the main image. To do this, simply click on the image you wish and select main image. You can also use the M key on your keyboard. Now when we select auto design and design, not only do we have our main cover photo here, we have our panorama here. We've also grouped together this spread of images, but now this is the main image on that spread. In gallery view and using the hotkeys M, C, P, and G, we can go through and storyboard our wedding in just a few minutes, so that when we do hit the auto design key, we know that the album should be exactly as we have planned it. But don't forget, you don't have to do this. You can use the auto design part of Fundy software to get a great first draft. But for those of us that would like a little bit more control, then you can go through and plan your album perfectly.